Pedro Martinez was here earlier this year, and he, in his book, talked about that 2004 team and how they would you would have a mixture of sort of rum and other things, and you would drink it for good luck. Everybody would take a sip, but that Manny Ramirez would sometimes put in, without anyone else knowing, some Viagra. True or false?
True story. It felt like we were smuggling flashlights playing catch. You know, an hour later, like, whoa! He would do his squats, right? I'm like, Manny, what do we got, bro? This is great stuff! You know, and if you could hit 40 and drive at 130 like he did, everybody tried it, right?
So sure.
That's what Manny does.
Why wouldn't you? Yeah. Yeah.
Last time you were here was right before an All-Star game. You went to the Home Run Derby this year, this year's All-Star game.
Cincinnati.
Now, you retired in 2008, but you still have fantastic hands. You caught a foul ball.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, I've been to so many Bucco games growing up. Yeah. My dad, bring the glove, never catch a foul ball. I'm 470 feet away in the left field corner, and Greg Amsler, the host for MLB Tonight, says, hey, sitting next to him, we got a big plate of ribs, you know, just crushing. So exciting, got a beer. I'm like, this is going to be a great Home Run Derby. And Greg Amsler's like, do you think Donaldson can hit it out here? I was like, dude, he could definitely hit it out here. So I go to just get a quick couple bites of ribs. He's like, here we go. I look up. I'm like, oh, my God, it's going to hit me right in the face. I just stand up. Boom, I catch the ball.
Now, I have to ask, you played. You had a long Major League Baseball career. Yeah. Yet you were super excited about this.
Oh, I was so excited. What are you doing?
Yeah, we have video proof here. Let's take a look. There we go. You can't even see what so far they hit. Yeah! Yeah, I like you were looking at it to make sure you didn't get barbecue sauce on it.
Oh, yeah, no.
No, 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 no. True story. And the picture we got on Twitter is like, hey, Case just caught blah, blah. Well, the problem was he said he was crushing ribs. He had it's like that asparagus commercial. Do I have anything in my teeth? And he had this piece of rib just hanging from his teeth. He's like, I got a ball. And no one told him. So we got like a huge, and there's like this black tube. It's like, he just got done crushing ribs. Fitbit, ladies and gentlemen.
You also, you participated in, as this was the celebrity softball game.
Oh, yeah.
And you did some practice, some wiffle ball practice on your set, on your MLB set with your co-host.
Lauren Shahadi.
Yep. And, before we show the tape, why don't you explain yourself?
Well, Shahadi played some high school softball. And she could have played in college a little bit, too. So I was like, hey, listen, after our show in the morning, let's go out to Studio 42, throw me a couple softballs so I can, you know, get the arc and see what's going on. I never really hit a softball before. And she threw me, like, 50 balls. I'm just rolling over on a few, and then,
I should point out, she's totally fine.
Oh, she's totally fine.
Hurt.
No wiffle balls were injured.
Nobody died, but let's take a quick look at what you did to her. Fine. Totally fine. Yeah.
Well, listen, as soon as I hit her, too, I was like, oh my gosh, is she okay? I go bolting out there as slow as can be, just like I'm running quicksand. Run out there. I pick her up. I'm like, Shahadi, you okay? She's like, yeah. I'm like, get a training staff in here real quick. I think she's bleeding, but she wasn't. She's
okay,
all right.
Everything fine.
Just a wiffle ball.
You used to, I it seems like now more than ever, and maybe you guys could do this, being a player in the MLB with. You know, all Twitter and everything, like, you've got to be careful of what you say because the press is always listening. Mm. You, however, took this to the other direction. You were happy the press was listening, and you would have a lot of fun with that in Boston.
The Boston scene and the press scene, you got to be careful, right?
Yeah.
Obviously. And, you know, I mean, the shots of Jack Daniels, next day we win a World Series, and I'm getting called by Mothers Against Drunk Drivers at that point.
Right.
Like, what? You know, you can't drink and have success, but
all
of this stuff goes on in that market, and that's what happens.
Yeah, a lot of attention.
Yep.
But you used to fake phone calls, right?
I used to walk off the bus, and you leave there, and there are people, and next thing you know, you got fans, right? Well, you can't sign for everybody, and if they got a two-minute bus, Seth, you got to roll, right?
Right, of course.
You got a stream of people. So, 1 second, guys. Okay, yeah, what? And you're walking through this roll, so we had the fake phone call walk of shame through the thing, right? It's like, hello? Yeah, and you're talking to mom. What? Come on, honey. And you start screaming, and then it gets more uptight. And then next thing you know, they're good. Like, whoa, that guy's crazy. Next, Lou Maloney, can I have your signature? Right?
So you pretended to be crazy.
Pretended to be crazy.
Not
wasn't
actually crazy.
Correct.
Gotcha. That's good to know. Yep.